What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel once again. It's underscore Kisaka. That's my YouTube channel name. So pleased to have you back. If you're not subscribed to the channel, kindly do me a favor by subscribing. Today, this is a special video. I'm gonna talk about two Jamaicans who left Jamaica and went to Canada and made history over there. One of the Jamaican guys is known as Ben Johnson, and the other is known as Donovan Bailey. So Ben Johnson, in the year 1988, that is when he was in the Olympics in Seoul, he made a history that took a lot of years to be broke by breaking 100 meters record. That is Ben Johnson. Even though later on the record was came to be nullified because they say that they were using performance enhancement drugs. And if I say by saying they, because in that race there were around 8 guys, and out of 8 people, 6 people were found to be using the performance enhancement drugs. So the record was nullified. And fast forward 8 years later, in Atlanta in the year 1996, Donovan Bailey, still a Jamaican, broke world record by running a time of 9.84. This was a surprise to many, and it is believed that Jamaicans are just winners, because the record that was run by Ben Johnson in the year 1988 nullified. Who is a Jamaican, and then another Jamaican just come forward after 8 years and breaks the record. Even though they are having citizenship of Canada, they are Jamaicans by blood. Jamaica is their home. That is where they come from. It is said that they were born in Jamaica and went to Canada and made history. There are some lessons to be learned from this. The first lesson is that Jamaicans are the fastest people on the planet. It is true that Jamaicans are the fastest people on earth. A good example is Usain Bolt. He broke his record. No, sorry, he broke 100 meter record by running 9.58. And up to now, it has been some years. No one has been able to break that record. And before that, Asafa Powell had was the one who was holding that record. And then a Jamaican, Asafa Powell is a Jamaican, and then another Jamaican broke that record. And you can see it has taken years. Still, people are struggling to break that record. Ben Johnson. After Ben Johnson doping scandal, Donovan Bailey, still a Jamaican, broke that record by 9.84. And if you look at the list of records of 100 meters dash, majority of the names are just Jamaicans that are on top. Talk of Ewan Blake, Usain Bolt, Asafa Powell, and the rest, most of them are Jamaicans. The second lesson, guys, you realize that Jamaicans are just naturally gifted and talented with a special gene. There's a gene that is said that Jamaicans just run fast. You may come up with different things to make them appear as if they like to try to find out how they run fast, but you'll never come into the exact root cause of how they run fast. It is just in their gene. It is a special gene. There's one thing in that race of Ben Johnson, the one in 1988, that they said he was doping, or he was using performance enhancement drug. If 6 people out of 8 were found to have used the performance enhancement drug, and Ben Johnson was the one who ultimately turned out to be the winner, then it means that even if you give all the sprinters performance enhancement drugs, it is likely there is high probability that a Jamaican is the one who will come out as a winner. Another lesson, guys, is Jamaicans mostly run below 10 seconds, which is not easy at all. In some places, especially in Africa here, it is not easy to find a person running below 10 seconds. I understand we have good names that who are even currently expected to compete in. There's an Olympics that is coming up. It is currently underway. There's some names which are who are running below 10 seconds, but it is in very rare occasions. It is if you compare that to Jamaicans, most of the Jamaicans run below 10 seconds. But here in Africa, majority struggle to go below the 10 seconds mark. Another lesson, guys, that we learn from Jamaicans is that if you your country is really struggling with a sprint, that is 100 meters dash and 200 meters dash, if you get to invite a Jamaican or you want to attain medals, if you incorporate Jamaicans, you are likely to you are most probably sure to clinch the medals. The UK tried that. The US tried that, like Sanya Richards. She is a Jamaican, and she won gold medals in the US in several competitions, that is Olympics and the rest. Australia, Japan, etc. Most of the people competing in the 100 meters dash, not most, some, and who win medals are Jamaicans. It shows you that Jamaica is a special country. Another reason they say that Jamaica, they are little but they talawa. They are little but they tall. They are tall. It's like everyone is talking about them, but it's just a little island. Jamaicans always have an effect. They always have a mark. They are little but they talawa. Recently, in this year 2024 Paris Olympics, there's one fan of Shelly-Ann Prize, a lady competing in 100 meters. She went crazy just seeing Shelly-Ann. Most of the 100 meters athletes really admire Usain Bolt from Jamaica with the way he did it, the way he broke the record 9.58. You can see a small island producing people who are admired globally. And not only in short races, but also in other stuff like in music, like reggae music. You can see how Jamaica has done. It has really produced reggae music that has spread messages, like one song of Bob Marley that really made a country like in Africa, like Zimbabwe, to really fought for their independence. And in fact, after gaining independence, they had to invite Bob Marley to come over and play at the function. So Jamaica is a small country, but its effect is really large. And also the love that Jamaicans have. And this is why, like, you have realized of late, most of Africans are recording videos about Jamaicans. It's because the love that Jamaicans show to us Africans. You know, one person in the comments section told me that I should stop recording videos about Jamaica and instead focus on Africa and my country. I told him that the love that Jamaicans show me is so much immense. And I don't know whether the fellow wants me to record videos about him or about, like, I'm recording videos about Jamaica, and I really love Jamaica because the love that you guys give me back is immense. The last reason, guys, is the talent in Jamaica cannot be exhausted. If you think that, like when the Jamaicans who went to other countries still win, still other Jamaicans rise up and win. When Asafa Powell broke the record and was almost retiring, Usain Bolt came over, broke a record. Jon Blake became the second fastest man, and he's still there, even though he's not competing in the Olympics, but he's still there. It is only because of some injuries. Recently, we are having guys like Oblique Seville, who are really promising. Kishen Thompson and Akeem Blake, they are really promising. And there are so many more to come. So you cannot... Jamaica is just naturally talented, and there are more talents that are coming up day in, day out. So this has been the video for today. Imagine Jamaicans going from Jamaica to Canada and raising the picture and the name, the flag of Canada high. Because I remember when Donovan Bailey won that gold by 9.84, the flag of Canada was lifted high, and the anthem of Canada was played only because of Jamaica. So this is the video for today. I wanted to talk about the two the two athletes who left Jamaica and went to Canada and gave a good name to Canada and left a mark there in Canada. Both of these sprinters are still alive. Ben Johnson is still alive, and Donovan Bailey is also still alive. I saw Donovan Bailey now has a YouTube channel. So this has been the video for today. Cheers, guys. Thank you for always coming back to watch my videos. If you have not subscribed to this channel, do me a favor by subscribing. And to my returning subscribers, I appreciate. I don't take your efforts for granted, for always taking your time to come back and watch my videos. So you can leave your comments down below so that I can know more, and also your predictions on this Olympics on I think on 3rd, that is when most of the sprints will be happening. How is it gonna be? Also, remember to share this video, guys. Support your brother from Africa. Thank you so much. Cheers. God's blessings.